Gayatri had long black hair. Reena was tall and fair. Usha was chirpy and bright. But Geeta always picked up a fight. All these lovely ladies have a very special place in my mind and my husband's heart. Ex-girlfriends? No, no, no. Some other women in his life? They better not. These lovely ladies, the angels of peace, the drivers of harmony, are the maids at my home. And in case you're wondering, why this special place? Because if they were not around, guess who would have been scrubbing, mopping, cleaning, cooking? Obviously, my husband. Mr. Context here, fellow Toastmasters, distinguished guests, demanding wives, submissive husbands, and all you bachelors, including you, Shashank, who wake up only when the maid constantly rings the doorbell. Welcome to the world of indispensable maid. 5 years down the line in my marriage, my husband figured out the perfect gift for our wedding night. Not the baby, he came later. The gift was a fully functional, fully trained, full-time maid. Yes, can you beat that? And life changed. Piles of dirty laundry disappeared. Cobwebs in every corner vanished. We could finally open the door and welcome guests home. After years and years of hoarding Sodexo coupons, feeding on McVeggie burgers, and putting the phone, the Domino's number on speed dial, we now had home-cooked food. That took 3 square meals a day. Can you beat that? And life was so different. When my maid handed over my lunch bag in this eco-friendly resonance bag and said, "Have a good day, madam." Madam, my ego would swell with pride. I call that the madam's pride. And at my office, my boss had always been pestering me. "Sumit, what matters is what you have to offer. What matters is what you bring to the table." Mr. Manager, my answer was hair. I bring to the table some yellow lentil, some mixed vegetable, some chapatis, apple raisin yogurt, some seasonal salad, a pre-lunch fruit, some post-lunch snack, and not to miss, some sundaes for the sweet dish. Life was perfect, and I became so famous for my advice on how to hire, train, retain, and sustain maids. I even updated my LinkedIn status saying advisory QA engineer and maid recommendation specialist. So there I was. But while maids are God's gift to the mankind, we women need to be slightly cautious. Yes, Vinita, yes, Sangeeta, yes, Punita. Remember? The way to a man's heart is through his stomach. And if that's true, then maids have a direct access to it. Every time my husband said, "Gayatri, what lovely chicken biryani," I would shudder and would be green with envy. But I can't tell you how many sleepless nights and heart burns I had every time chicken biryani was made at home. But I decided of revenge, enough of it, and I increased her workload. "Gayatri, can you get me a glass of water? Something like 50 times a day? Gayatri, can you please change the TV channel? Gayatri, can you please count my R's and ums?" I knew she was feeling the heat, I knew that. But one fine morning, when I woke up, there was no bed tea. I shouted, "Gayatri, where's my Betty? Gayatri, you there?" There was no response. I looked everywhere, in the balcony, in the washroom, the bedroom. I looked under the tables, beside the sofa, behind the curtains. She was nowhere. Can you guess what happened? She had left. I felt like a VP education whose general evaluator was bagged out. I was thoroughly shocked, but I put together myself. Cobwebs came back and piles of laundry with hair. This time, I had nothing to bring to the table. I went back and sadly picked up the broom and handed it over to my husband. While I went on a new mission to find a new maid, by God's grace, I found a new one in the form of Bubbly. Bubbly is very dear to me and I take good care of her. I have learned from Sam today that you should not take life and maid for granted. I ensure that she's not asked for a glass of water 50 times a day. I carry my own water bottle. I ensure that I don't ask her to change TV channels. I sit through Big Boss and vote on her behalf. Best part, not only can she count my hours and arms, but she can also play the timer too. Life is on the right track, but I still miss Bubbly. And I get nightmares of she running away. I realize that the greatest fear for me is not the fear of death. It's not even the fear of public speaking. It's the fear of losing a maid. The answer to this I found with my Almighty, and every night I pray, thank you, Lord, for the food and tea. Thank you, Lord, for the maid that you gave me. Bless my maid on a cleaning spree so that my husband can be slightly free. Let my maid never run away from me, and I shall pray each night in glee, and I shall pray each night in glee. Amen.